says he stands with auto workers, but as president, Donald Trump passed tax breaks for his rich friends while automakers shuttered their plants and Michigan lost manufacturing jobs. Joe Biden said he'd stand up for workers, and he's delivering, passing laws that are increasing wages and creating good-paying jobs. Manufacturing is coming back to Michigan because Joe Biden doesn't just talk, he delivers.
The Biden campaign threw some serious jabs at their political opponent, Donald Trump, and that is their latest political ad. Now, the unflattering golfing shots of the former president and details about manufacturing plants closing during his tenure, I believe, really, really matter and could help Biden in this campaign. And look, this comes as Trump is set to skip the Republican primary debates and address non-union workers in Michigan today. Now, this ad will air nationally, including in Michigan, of course. And according to the Biden-Harris campaign, Delivers, which is the title of this new ad, will run on national cable channels and on TV and digital in Michigan. This ad is part of Team Biden-Harris's 16-week, $25 million advertising campaign that is reaching key voters in battleground states and includes the largest and earliest investment in Hispanic and African American media for a re-election campaign in history. And according to Kevin Munoz, who is a campaign spokesperson for the Biden-Harris campaign, he says more empty promises in Michigan or anywhere else can't erase Donald Trump's egregious failures and broken promises to America's workers. He can't hide his anti-labor, anti-jobs record from the countless American workers he's let down. This election will be a choice between President Biden's real advocacy for working class Americans or working Americans and a rerun of billionaire Donald Trump's broken promises to the middle class. And to be clear, while we obviously have our critiques and criticisms in regard to the job that President Joe Biden has done so far, I would say that the highlight of his presidency so far is his National Labor Relations Board. And he has been very pro-labor relative to other presidents, including Democratic administrations. And so he does deserve credit in that arena. And I'll explain more of that in just a moment. But Cenk, what do you think?
I think it's a good start and it's a good sign because they're focusing on the right things. So, and I don't mean Donald Trump's waistline, although that's a fun little addition. Mainly that he's full of crap on jobs and wages, etc. Sean Fain, the head of the UAW, did a fantastic job with this on CNN the other night. But he's not a part of the Democratic Party. He also takes shots at Biden and he's fair. And that's what part of why we like him. But if you're being fair, yes, Biden's record is definitely better than Donald Trump's record. Donald Trump doesn't even believe in minimum wage. He says your wages should be potentially even lower than $7.25 an hour. He's never supported the workers ever. Ever. A lot of BS talk spewing out of his mouth, but never backs it up. But he did deliver for those corporations big time. And recently he was just, commenting about how much, the poor corporations can't catch a break. So that's who he is. He's a fake populist, and that this ad is beginning to expose that is a good sign.
Now, I agree. I think that it makes a lot of sense to touch on the issues that the majority of Americans, including even those on the right wing, care deeply about, and the unequal society we live in, the economic system that has only increased and exacerbated inequality is something that Americans are frustrated about, which is why the faux populist messaging coming from Donald Trump in 2016 unfortunately did resonate, even though we all know talk is cheap and he didn't put any action behind those words. Now, with that said though, what I find really fascinating about the response or reaction to Biden's latest campaign ad is how establishment Democrats have reacted to it. They feel that Biden should have focused his attacks on Donald Trump's 91 indictments instead of the workers' issues. Many would like to see Biden go after Trump on those indictments. In fact, even Joe Scarborough weighed in on this. Now, to be fair, this is on September 8th. So this wasn't after he saw the Biden attack ad, but in this Morning Joe segment, they were discussing how Biden needs to attack Trump. And when you watch this video, you'll get a sense on what they want the attacks to look like. Let's watch.
The judge said that by any definition used by the US Army, used by the American Medical Association, used by any other organization, Donald Trump was a rapist. I think people might want to hear that, and they may want to hear that he stole nuclear secrets, and they may want to hear from Joe Biden that he's been charged with stealing secret war plans. I mean, these are very relevant to who the next president of the United States should and should not be.
So we should address two things. Number one, the efficacy of the type of attack ads that, you know, people like Joe Scarborough are asking for. But also, I think it's worth having a discussion about why it is that the Democratic establishment wants Biden to kind of shy away from the, you know, workers related attack ads against Biden and instead focus on the 91 indictments, which, to be quite frank, I don't think will be as effective, but I could be wrong. What do you think, Cenk?
So, you know me, I'd hit him with everything I got. And so people always talking about, should we do this or that? Why don't you do one thing in ads and have your surrogates do another and have Biden do a third? So look, it's a good sign that has a pulse, because this is the first ad he's run. Meanwhile, Donald Trump has run countless ads against Ron DeSantis and has already pummeled him and destroyed him. So the idea that you keep your powder dry is, I've got a word for it, it's dumb. It is inexcusable, inarguable. There is no evidence that keeping your powder dry is somehow going to magically help you. No, making your case helps you. If you don't make your case, you're a stupid person. So here they have at least begun. They've taken the first step. I'm trying to be positive. It's a good ad. It's a good sign, etc. Now, having said that, if you have a limited amount of money and you do for ads, they have a giant amount of money, but it's still limited. You have to know how to prioritize what you're going to emphasize. I would definitely emphasize economic issues. I would emphasize anything that affects the average American. And because, guys, here's what you don't need too many ads on. Everybody already knows Donald Trump's a terrible person. Terrible, right? So the Democrats know that he's terrible. Most of the independents know that he's terrible. And a lot of MAGA that likes him because he's terrible. You're not gonna change any minds over that, right? So, I mean, remember in the Republican town hall that CNN conducted, when they talked about how he raped that poor woman, the crowd gave him an ovation. So I'm not a Republican, that's on them. And you could say, oh, maybe it's not a representative sample, but they were pretty loud. So that's not gonna work, okay? And we're not trying to flip Republicans anyway, we're trying to flip independents, right? So why is going after the average, his record on the average man versus your record better and more effective? Because it's about the voter. Mm-hmm. The voter doesn't care about your drama and your soap opera.
Yep.
The voter cares about their own lives. And it's remarkable that politicians, after being in politics for 50, 100, 200 years, still don't know that. And they're still, and by the way, including media pundits, and they're still having a debate over that. There is no debate over that. Again, you don't know much about politics if you don't know that you're supposed to appeal to your voters and not get obsessed with your own self. But again, here, guys, I want to be clear. Out of the gate, the first ad is good. It's good. I don't want you to think it's criticism of the ad. The ad is very good. In that case, I'm criticizing mainstream media saying, don't focus on economic issues and focus on his character.
Right. And so, look, I think the biggest flaw in that thinking is just being so tethered to conventional wisdom that the establishment has difficulty understanding how things have changed and what actually appeals to ordinary voters. So look, it is true that when it comes to campaigning on economic policy, if you get too wonky and you get too complicated in what you're proposing, yeah, eyes will glaze over and some of the culture war related topics will grab way more attention. But in this particular case, I think that the ad is so good in making an economic issue clear and easy to understand, right? Manufacturing jobs went away under Donald Trump's watch. There's obvious inequality. Biden is supportive of like the striking workers. And he did address the striking workers in Michigan, which we'll talk about a little later in the show. And so simplifying that economic message, I think, is effective. Trump is a good example of how simplifying that economic message and pretending to care about ordinary people and their livelihoods. Like, it was effective in 2016. I think Biden leaning into that and actually having the receipts to prove that he's better on those issues than Trump is a better strategy than avoiding attacking Trump at all or just focusing on how Trump is a bad guy.
Look, I know what I would do, but God forbid that you know, corporate Democratic consultants should listen to us. But all right, guys, you're gonna look, you tell me whether you think this makes sense. So I would pick specific instances of Donald Trump saying something where he did not deliver. Every one of them has to be about the average American, okay? So I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna bring you so many jobs, and then show the actual record. And then every time that you show one of his lies, I would have some sort of graphic of vomit coming out of his mouth, right? or like he just vomits out this information, these lies all the time. And every time I would prove lie, lie, and then I would emphasize, this guy's a phony. He's a total phony. He's trying to trick you. Are you gonna fall for his tricks? Are you gonna fall for the tricks of this cheap con man? Because then that asks the audience, wait, is it true or is it not true? Because if it's not true, then you, wait a minute, I am falling for the tricks of a cheap con man, mm-hmm. right? So challenge them on it. And so I would prove 1,000 times over how he is not for you. He's only in it for himself. And I would and the main thing I would pound away at is the number one example, once you got past the economic issues that affect that are policy, is what did he do with all the money he raised from the MAGA guys?
Oh yeah. Totally.
Because I'm gonna show look out for you guys. Right? And then it took a couple hundred million dollars. Where is it, Donnie? Where is it? And they should keep asking, where's the money that you raised? Because I guarantee you it went in, a ton of it went into his properties. So let's go smarten up and actually run a race against this guy. So thank you for showing up. I think it's super late. You better start running. You better start running. If you're not gonna get out of the race, run super aggressively. Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.